The government and the deputy chairperson of the Rajya Sabha had justified passing the farm bills in the Rajya Sabha through a voice vote on the 20th of September, stating that the opposition members weren't in their seats when they asked for the division of votes. But what exactly does Rajya Sabha Television's own footage show? Take a look at what exactly happened in the House. Was this all cleared through a voice vote correctly according to the rule book?
This is the CPM leader KK Rajesh at his seat in the upper gallery of the Rajya Sabha on the 20th of September. Tiruchi Siva, DMK MP, is saying the same demand. Instead, the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha, who was presiding, did this. He pushed through the farmer bills through a voice vote. Opposition leaders say Harivansh Singh's conduct that day was in violation of at least three parliamentary laws. In this case, the most important rule being Rule 252, which says that if a decision of a Rajya Sabha question is challenged, he shall order a division to be held under which the votes can be recorded and the matter decided. In this case, opposition MPs, as the Rajya Sabha video indicates, quite clearly asked for a division. This wasn't considered.
Two times consecutively I had asked for division. Both those demands were blatantly neglected, violated, and I think it is a very, very conscious, deliberate move.
The government insists that the opposition MPs were not at their seats.
If you have to do voting, then you know that you have to go to voting for your seat. 13 times, the Up Sabhapati Mani Harivansh Ji has asked you to go to your seat.
While there's little doubt that opposition MPs, including the Trinamool MP Derek O'Brien, were aggressive in rushing to the well of the House and facing off against the Deputy Speaker, the video also seems to indicate the circumstances in which they did this. Opposition leaders argue that Rule 37, which calls for the Chair to get a sense of the House before deciding on extending a session, was not being considered, even though at least 12 parties wanted the House to adjourn as planned at 1 p.m. so that voting on the bills could be taken up the following day.
Please get something. I shall now put cross.
Almost all the opposition parties were on our legs, around 12 parties. We said, please kindly adjourn the House, we can have it tomorrow. We don't understand, first of all, why this bill has been brought as an, why it was first promulgated as an ordinance, then why it is being rushed to be passed in this session itself, and why on that particular day itself, not even to the next day. Maybe they are concerned or worried about their numbers.
The government insists that there was absolutely nothing wrong in extending the session.
Lok Sabha mein kitni baar hua hai ki house ke kaam pura hone tak, bill ke hone tak house ko badha dete hain. Raj Sabha mein hua hai.
While the government blames opposition parties for creating ruckus during the voting of farm bills in Raj Sabha, the opposition parties say they were forced to come to the well of the house only because the deputy chairman did not follow the rules. As both government and opposition parties say, it's indeed a black day in the history of Indian Parliament as such important bills were passed by mere voice vote. With camera person Manu Nair, this is Arvind Gunasekar for NDTV.
Well, joining us now, Lieutenant General D.P. Vats, Rajya Sabha MP of the BJP. We are also joined by Sanjay Hegde, Senior Advocate of the Supreme Court, and K.K. Rajesh, CPM MP in the Rajya Sabha. Let me go across first to General Vats. General, if there were at least two MPs who were at their seat asking for a division, wasn't the Deputy Chairperson obliged to allow division of votes to take place in the Rajya Sabha?
Mr. Som, I would like to point it out that the visuals what you have been showing are not complete ones and not the proper sequence of events. exactly what has happened means once they ask for a division on the resolution, then the galleries have to be cleared. But prior to that, before the division comes, first was about the continuation of the house. About the continuation of the house, you see, the rule position says the sense of the house. And
yes,
who is to decide the sense of the house was, this is the own judgment of the deputy chairman or chairman. There the things have started. The opposition MPs came rushed to the well of the house, started shouting slogans, tore the rule books, mounted the platform, and then even they used abusive language against the deputy chairman. Under these situations, now you tell me, is division possible?
Right.
As far as division is concerned.
Right. As far what about as sense? So 2 points, sir, General Vats, respectfully. The video we've actually gone through very, very carefully. And the video shows a couple of things very clearly. And in fact, we've got one of the CPM MPs over here who we'll come to in a moment for what he says, because he featured in that video. He's got his arms up and he is asking for division. So irrespective of whether you feel that the sequence of events isn't correct, if there are MPs asking for division, as I understand it and as we've showed in the rule book, you have to have division. Why did that not happen?
You see, you have to create a situation for division. Galleries have to be cleared. Everybody has to go to his seat. And then they have to sit. Slips have to be supplied. Now, it is not possible under these situations when the MPs are sitting in galleries, in Lok Sabha, in Rajya Sabha. By the way, I was in Lok Sabha. But we were listening to the deputy chairman and we were seeing the visuals also. Though they say the television was set off, Rajya Sabha TV was set off, but we were seeing it inside the house, whether it is Rajya Sabha chamber or Lok Sabha chamber. Therefore, once the members don't sit and there are no proper situations,
no, I take that point. I accept the point that a lot of opposition MPs were completely... it seemed almost out of control at one stage. I'll get to my other guests in a moment, but one more question for you, General Vats. When you said sense of the house and that the sense of the house is something that needs to be decided by the deputy chair in this case, what about the 12 opposition parties, at least, who believe the sense of the house for them was such that the voting should have taken place the next day, that they did not want to extend beyond 1 p.m. Shouldn't the deputy chair have accepted or recognized what they felt?
You see, even leader of opposition has mentioned that consensus, but it is sense. Then who is to decide the sense? Sense is to be decided by the deputy chairman or the chairman who is in chair.
Okay.
Now, his decision is from his, sense that it was comfortable to extend the house. You see, opposition parties, either they sit, cooperate, and even there on this also there is a clause 3 of division. But that situation didn't reach. Opposition behaved in such a irresponsible manner.
Okay, General, one moment. I want to go across to KK Ragesh. Mr. Ragesh, question number one. When you were at your seat and you were protesting, you were raising your hands, were you or were you not asking for division?
See, I had moved the statutory resolution and around 12:55, the deputy chairman had called the minister to reply. And he had started replying. And at 1 o'clock, he had taken the sense of the house for extending the house for some more time for the passage of both the bills. At that time, we were opposing. Why? Because we have decided to ask for division on, so far as my party is concerned, on statute resolution, on the motion to send the bill to a select committee, and also
all the amendments, eight amendments had already been moved, and on all the amendments.
So and you were at your seat and you were asking for division of votes, yes or no? I just want to understand the sequence so that we're accurate about it.
I was asking for division on statute resolution first, then on the motion to send that.
You were asking for division, in other words, a vote to take place on multiple grounds, and you were in your seats. The reason I asked this is because many MPs weren't in their seats, and that has to be condemned as well. You cannot have uproarious scenes like what we saw that day in the Raj. But the point I'm asking is this, because the government says that you cannot have a division unless all MPs are at their seats. Do you believe that there is some importance in what the deputy chair says over there? You may have been in your seat. Tiruchi Siva may have been in their seat. We saw them. But others weren't. Derek O'Brien wasn't. So therefore, legally, what is your view on this?
Mr. Vishnuji, can you show me any single provision in the rule book that permit the deputy chairman to pass a bill in DIN? When a single member,
true,
he may be a single member party. If a single member asks for a division, it is the responsibility of the chair to see that a division has taken place. But unfortunately, what the deputy chairman had done, see, from the 14 that you had already published, it is very clear that I was asking for division from the seat which was allocated to me itself. And again, so far as this session is concerned, how can you ask for a division from their seat? That is also very a tricky question, because most of the members are sitting in Lok Sabha.
So let me bring in a legal expert, Sanjay Hegde, with us as well. Mr. Hegde, one way or the other, this was a difficult situation for the deputy chair. You did have aggressive MPs rushing him, and he didn't allow a voting to take place, a division to take place. Legally, did he break any rules?
See, the first thing that you must realize is that legally, within the House, the decision of the chairman binds.
Yes.
If you are asking me whether a court will get into the inner working of a house, no, normally a court does not. But here was an important rule of the house that any member could ask for a division. A division was in fact asked for, and it was not granted. So it's since the IPL is going on these days, let me give you an example. Supposing a batsman asks for a review, and the review is not granted, and you say you're out. Would that be valid? Or could a court? Of course, a court would not get into what happens on the ground. But nevertheless, when the legal validity of that act is tested in court, I'm sure that this will be a circumstance that will be taken into account.
Mr. Hegde, now that Rashtrapati Bhavan has actually signed off on this, and therefore it will become a law now, can the courts actually still intervene? Hypothetically. No.
The courts can always review any legislation, but they normally review it on specific grounds of the Constitution, that it violates any provision of the Constitution, or that it is manifestly arbitrary. Now, one of the grounds that will no doubt be raised before the courts is that it was not passed in the correct manner. You may remember that even the Aadhaar bill was questioned that way, that it was not really a money bill, yet it was passed through the Rajya Sabha. So similarly, all these procedural lapses, if any, will necessarily have to be taken into account if there is a challenge, that is.
All right. K.K. Ragesh, in a situation like that, when there was a great deal of aggression showed by certain MPs, you were seated in the upper gallery. You may not have been very much at the eye level of the deputy chair. And he took a decision to push through with this. And he also took a decision not to extend the session the next day. And as Mr. Hegde was suggesting, it's ultimately what he decides that's final. You can question it later in a court of law or not. That's a larger issue. But this is a call that he has taken. Why would you believe that he has taken this call if he didn't believe it to be correct?
See, See, the basic issue is that the deputy chairman's decision had instigated all the unfortunate things that had happened in the house. Because I had already told you, we have been asking for division repeatedly from our own seats, and it is our right as a member of the house, it is our right to ask for division, and it is the responsibility of the chair to see that the division had happened, which was unfortunately violated. Why they are doing so? Because I think there is a larger conspiracy involved in it. Because four political parties which used to support the government every time, whenever there is a crisis, you can see that these four political parties used to support them. One is BJD, TRS, ADMK, and also their own Ali, Shiromani Akali Dal. All these parties, four parties, were opposed to this bill, and they were all demanding for sending the bill to a select committee. And if these parties are going to vote against the government, and also, as you and myself know very well, that many of the members were absent there because many of them were affected with corona, and many of them were on quarantine, and that is why many members were absent. And that is why the BJP government was very clear, ministers were very clear, that they are not going to, the bill is not going to be passed in the house, and our demand for sending the bill to a select committee is going to be to be accepted by the house. And that is why they know that very well, and that is why they went for this game plan. This is extremely unconstitutional. It is against the rules of the procedure of Rajya Sabha, and of course it is unforeseen. Okay. We had never seen such kind of a situation.
Okay,
in the
let
house.
Me go back. And let me go back, sir, to General Vats. General Vats, what was the problem with a division of votes? The BJP has always said, look, we have the numbers, it's not an issue. Why not have a division of votes? Is a very simple thing. You would have potentially have won it if you had the numbers.
As I mentioned to you, and I heard Deputy Chairman saying repeatedly, division will only be possible if you go to seats. And everybody goes to seats, then these slips will be distributed and galleries will be cleared, then division will be possible. Opposition members didn't listen to him, they didn't obey him, they didn't go to their seats, let it be Ragesh or Trishu Shiva, that is okay, but they were also standing, they have to be seated before the division. Now, once, twice, thrice, with repeated requests, if the members are not cooperating, then he has taken this recourse, which is very much justified. As far as our majority
But General, I understand the opposition was out of hand, but does that justify a voice vote being pushed through?
That's what I feel. If the opposition is out of hand, then what is the alternative?
And the alternative is that you adjourn the House and you start proceedings on the next day or whenever you want.
You see, it was just a question of 10-15 minutes only, not more than that.
But and sir, you just said the opposition MPs were out of control, and the opposition MPs were out of control. They did stall the... How would it be 10 to 15 minutes?
What I say, this is deliberate. Means if they don't want to cooperate, you can wake up a sleeping person, but you cannot wake up a wake-up person. That was the situation.
Okay.
They didn't want to cooperate. Why? They are saying we were in minority. We were not in minority. They were in minority. There, most of the MPs, especially elderly MPs like Manmohan Singh ji, Chidambaram ji, even Manish Gupta ji, Mukhopadhyay ji, they were all on leave, and leave was granted to them. They were very thinly present, and we were present.
Okay, I just want to interrupt you now because we've got a reaction from the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha. And from what I understand of this, the deputy chairman does agree that Tiruchi Shiva did demand division from the seat, but goes on to say that the order of the house is essential for division to take place. So very similar to what you're arguing, General Vats. The order of the House was not maintained, is what the deputy chair has to say. Sanjay Hegde, my question to you is therefore is this: does one justify the other? Does the lack of courtesy, behavior, aggression, call it what you want, of some opposition MPs justify the deputy chair pushing this through a voice vote?
See, the deputy chair ultimately embodies the House. If the deputy chair then pushes one piece of legislation this way today, tomorrow there may be another government, another deputy chair pushing another piece of legislation. Is that how we as a nation want our highest lawmaking bodies to act? I was reminded of the Lokpal bill where Vice President Hamid Ansari was working right through the night to try and get it passed, and then there was one member who tore up the bill, and then that session was adjourned. To run a house is normally the prerogative of the government. The government does reach out to the opposition, talk to them, and get things done. There have been moments in history where the opposition has not cooperated, and the NDA has done that during the Congress regime. It is at that time that things have to be worked out. You need healthy relations. You can't say, I am in power now, I am going to push this legislation through, and the rest be damned.
Because so that's an important point.
A bad message to the country.
I think that's an important point, Mr. Hegde, and I need to wrap this up. Perhaps it was parliamentary procedure, parliamentary propriety, and standards and precedent which has been changed or done away with in this particular instance. But the legality of it, that's, it's an open book on whether something illegal was strictly done. One way or the other, this is now law. But the big question is, what does this mean in terms of future sessions of Parliament? Will there be concrete debate? Will the sense of the opposition be taken? What happens next? I'd like to thank all three of you very much for joining us. Well, just returning to our top story, the big debate we've had on this program on whether parliamentary rules were followed when the farmer bill was pushed through a voice vote in the Rajya Sabha. The deputy chair has now issued a statement. This is with regard to several news items which appeared on his conduct on that day. And he says, number one, the statutory resolution disapproving the ordinance and the amendment for the reference of the bill to a select committee moved by Sri Ragesh was negated by a voice vote by the House at 107, as Sri Ragesh was in the well of the House and not on his seat in the gallery at that point of time. Number two, it is true that Sri Tiruchi Siva demanded a division on his amendment for reference to his bill to a select committee from his seat at 1:10 p.m. You'll see from the same video, and video has been submitted as well, that around 1:09 p.m. one member was tearing the rule book and throwing on me. Besides, I was surrounded by some hostile members who were trying to snatch papers from me. Should be mentioned that Derek O'Brien says that he wasn't trying to tear the rule book. Number three, you will appreciate that as per rules and practice, in order to have a division, two things are essential. Firstly, there should be a demand for division, and equally important that there should be order in the House. I think as the video footage we have showed you indicates, there was a demand for a division. Mr. Ragesh over here mentioned that he was in his seat earlier on, and he did want demand, and he certainly did want it. The deputy chair also mentions it is true that Sri Tiruchi Siva demanded a division on his amendment. So there were two instances there, but the deputy chair says that first there should be a demand for division, and equally important that there should be order in the House. The larger issue of whether or not the voice vote shouldn't have been pushed through does remain a debate. One way or the other, it's now the law, with the president having signed it earlier today.